PyData Archive has the functionality for the so-called auto-archiving. With this function enabled, your PyData Archive has the automatic capability to create new archives as and when the current primary archive becomes full. On the same note, it's worth mentioning that the auto-archiving will only be able to create new archives if there is enough disk space on the drive that holds the archives. So let's go ahead and see how it's supposed to work. First, let's go and open the Py System Management tool from Start, All Programs, Py System, and selecting Py System Management Tools. Then click on Operations and click on Archives. Here we currently have only one archive, and this one archive is a primary archive, and there is nothing else. Note that primary archive is the archive to which current values are being written into. When the primary archive becomes full, it will start overwriting itself. However, with auto archiving enabled, this can be avoided. So let's see how to enable auto archiving functionality. Now, once again, click on Tuning Parameters option under Operations and click on the Archives tab. Here, we note that there is a variable called archive underscore auto archive file route. And we note that the value is set to blank right now, indicating that the auto archiving functionality is not enabled. Now, let's set the auto archiving functionality. So, double click on this particular parameter, and we know that currently we have our Py archives under C Py arc folder. Let's copy this path and paste it, followed by a backslash. And now we can give the name of the PyData archive, which is PySRB1 underscore. Kindly note that as a standard, we specify the name of the PyData archive followed by an underscore, so that if the PyData archive is migrated to a different server, you can tell that the archives came from an older server. So once we have this, I can say OK. And by doing this operation, we have ensured that the auto archiving functionality is enabled. Now that we have enabled the auto archiving functionality, let's go ahead and test it to see whether it works. So to test it, kindly go back to the archives, which is under Operations and Archives. Click on this one. And currently we note that there is only one archive, which is the primary archive. So to test the auto archiving functionality, we need to hit this button, which is called forced and archive shift. So let's do an archive shift and acknowledge yes. And lo and behold, a new archive has been created. And now this new archive, which has the name of the PyData archive, which is namely PySRB1, followed by the date and time when the archive was created. And this is marked as primary. And the old primary archive has now been marked as has data. Now that we have enabled auto archiving and confirmed it is also working, we do not need to worry about data being overwritten when primary archive fills up, as now new archives will be automatically be generated, assuming there is enough disk space available on the archive drive.